السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I am Dr. Elbialy, lecturer of diabetes and endocrinology. This session is about diabetes and other system affections. Infections and diabetes actually is adversarial status. Infection can lead to diabetes. Diabetes can also lead to infection. Why diabetes increases the risk of infection? Due to abnormality in cell-mediated immunity, decrease the antibody formation from the B cell, decrease the phagocytic function, and hyperglycemia is a good media for bacteria, decrease the vascularity, autonomic neuropathy that affects diabetic foot, leading to dryness of the skin, leading to fissure. This fissure may ulcerate or may act as a passage for the infection leading to cellulite. Effects of infection in diabetes. Infection is a stressful condition, release cortisol, leading to increased insulin resistance, leading to difficulty to control blood glucose. It can precipitate diabetic ketosis. Also, in patients susceptible to be diabetic, the precipitated occurrence of the virus. Common infection in diabetes. Skin, staphylococcal infection, foil, abscess, mucocutaneous skin diseases due to fungal infection. As a result, the gastrointestinal, emphysematous cholecystitis in the gallbladder, periodontal disease and losing of the teeth, urinary tract infection, emphysematous pyelonephritis, brain nephric abscess also is common. In the lung pneumonia, TB follows diabetes like its shadow, osteomyelitis, rhinocerebral mycormycosis, which is a lethal disease due to fungal infection, and malignant cystitis extra. To prevent a diabetic foot infection, you must control your blood sugar. To keep it fasting, the blood glucose below 140, 2-hour boost the brandy at below 180, to keep the hemoglobin A1C around 6. Good hygiene and vaccination with pneumococcal and influenza vaccine. To treat a diabetic infection, early and proper diagnosis is must, and early start of antimicrobial. If your patient was an oral, shift it on insulin, especially if the infection was. Gastrointestinal complications of diabetes. In the mouth, periodontal disease, with losing of the teeth, and the gum inflammation. Esophagus, GERD, which is gastroesophageal reflux disease, due to decreased in lower esophageal sphincter, pressure, or delayed gastric emptying. Gastroparesis, which is due to delayed gastric emptying, presented by early satiety, nausea, vomiting, bloating, and postprandial abdominal pain. Unexplained poor glycemic control due to inappropriate timing with the insulin. We diagnose it when we done the endoscopy and found residual food in the stomach after an overnight fast. The gold standard diagnosis is scintigraphic measurement of gastric emptying after swallowing of scintigraphic tablets. Treatment: small meals. Avoid fatty meals, use of prokinetic like metoclopramide, and avoid the use of GLP-1, which is side effect increases gastroparesis of late gastric symptoms. Diabetic enteropathy, which is diarrhea mainly, which is watery and bended, especially at night, may be associated with fecal incontinence. The bouts may occur in bouts. It may occur with intermittent normal bowel habits. It may alternate with constipation. In addition, steatorrhea can occur due to bacterial overgrowth. To treat this diarrhea, must exclude infectious foods. If there are water and electrolyte imbalance, try to correct it. And try to control blood sugar and to replace nutritional deficiency. Symptomatic therapy is the antidiarrheal agent such as loperamide. In the liver, non-alcoholic fatty liver and non-alcoholic steatohepatitis is common. Cholecystitis, especially epidemic cholecystitis, is common in diabetic patients. Skin and diabetes. Acanthosis nigrum, which is brown, velvety, hyperpigmented flakes in the neck, in the back, in the axilla, like this foot. Necrobiosis libotica diboticola. It's a painful violet flake with central yellowish area surrounded by brownish borders. Usually occur over the chin of the leg. Usually there are central ulcerations. It is resistant in the treatment. Can be treated by controlling blood sugar, local steroids, dermatological consultation is a must, even skin graft, it may be required. Diabetic dermatitis, spotted leg syndrome. At the beginning, it is reddish, then it becomes brown and hyperpigmented. It is due to atrophic skin. Bullosis diabeticorum is non-inflamed bully with sterile fluid heal within 2-3 weeks without visible scars. Granuloma annulare, excess papule with rounded shape, the breast center, usually on the dorsum of the hand and arm. Diabetic thick skin on the fingers and the hands, leading to inability to do non-Islamic prayer. Scleroderma diabeticorum, the thickening occurs in the neck and in the upper back. Carotidemia, which is a yellowish coloration of the skin and nail. Skin ulcers, like in this photo. There are two types of ulcers, vascular and neuropathic ulcers. Sign of hyperlipidemia can be obvious in the skin, like xanthelasma, which is a yellowish flake around the eye, like in this photo, or erratic xanthoma, which is a yellow papule or nodule, usually on an extensor surface. Skin infection may be fungal, may be bacteria leading to abscess, cellulite, erythrocyte. Fungal infection, like that occurs in the foot, between the toes, named senior digits or athletic foot, due to moisture between the toes. So that we take our patient to keep the area dry between the toes. Skin and the antibiotic medication, an insulin can lead to lipoatrophy or lipohypertrophy. Sulfonylurea drug eruption like side effects of drug allergy. Then diabetes and the breeding. Classification. If the patient is known to be diabetic before gestation, so that the type of diabetes is 1 or type 2 diabetes, or gestational diabetes, which is carbohydrate intolerance that begin in pregnancy. For developing gestational diabetes, family history of diabetes, previous gestational diabetes, age more than 25, previous delivery of macrosomic baby more than 4 kg, polycystic ovary syndrome, current use of glucocorticoids, certain ethnicities, African American or South or East Asian, pregnancy body mass index greater than in pre-pregnancy, for pregnancy body mass index greater than 30. How will pregnancy affect the diabetic state? Yes, it affects due to hyperinsulinemia and increased insulin resistance due to placental hormones like the placental lactogen, increased progesterone, as well as pregnant ladies eat more and decrease its exercise, decrease her exercise. Diabetic retinopathy worsens in pregnancy. Diabetic nephropathy also worsens, but it returns to the normal retinopathy and the nephropathy after the pregnancy. nephropathy to return to the normal, it must in absence of and controlled hypertension, and serum creatinine concentration must be below 1.5 milligram per liter. Pregnancy doesn't affect the neuro. Effects of diabetes on pregnancy. As regards the fetus and the neonatal complications, congenital malformation is common, like congenital heart defects, caudal dyskinesia, neural tube defects, macrosomia or large baby size with associated with shoulder dystopia and resulting in increased rate of cesarean section, neonatal hypoglycemia, erythrocytosis, hyperbilirubinemia, prematurity with respiratory problems. Maternal complications like spontaneous abortion, stillbirth, hypertension, preeclampsia, polyhydramnios, urinary tract infections, recurrence of gestational diabetes in subsequent pregnancy. Gestational diabetes increases the risk of developing type 2 diabetes. Whom to screen? Universal screening is a must. How to screen? In the first prenatal visit, to differentiate between the over-diabetes or gestational diabetes. Over-diabetes is like the ordinary numbers of diabetes, fasting greater than 126 or equal to that, or A1C greater than or equal to 6.5. At 24 to 28 weeks of gestation, we can do one-step approach, which is done by giving the pregnant lady 25 grams of blood of glucose. Then we measure blood sugar 1 hour postprandial and 2 hour postprandial. If the fasting was greater than or equal to 92, but lesser than 126, or 1 hour is greater than 180, or 2 hours is greater than or equal to 153. Any one abnormal reading, it is diagnosed as gestational diabetes. Other method is a two-step. The first step in the two-step is giving to the patient 50 gram oral glucose. If the blood sugar is greater than or equal to 130, we proceed to 75 gram 2 hour oral glucose therapy. How to treat? At the beginning, you must know that the target blood glucose is different, not like the diabetic non-pregnant diabetes. If fasting must be kept below or equal to 95, 1 hour to be postprandial to be below or equal to 140, with 2 hours postprandial to be kept around 120. Glucose level shouldn't decrease to less than 6. Treatment of any diabetes is formed from diet, exercise, and drugs. Diet, weight loss, and pregnancy is not generally recommended. So the aim of diet is to prevent excessive weight. If the patient has ideal body weight, the caloric requirement is 30 kilocalories per kilogram per day. If the patient is overweight, the caloric requirement is about 25 kilocalories per kilogram per day. If the patient is obese, it's about 14 kilocalories per kilogram per day. Insulin, regular insulin, insulin levels, will insulin aspart, NPH, D-dimer have acceptable safety profile, while insulin glargine and the glulose hasn't been studied extensively in pregnancy. Oral medication like glipizide in the market like Duanil and the metformin in the market like Sibutramine can be given if the patient refuses taking the insulin or in the early stage. and thank you.